All right, so we are finally live. Sorry about the delay, guys. There's a DDoS attack, which is basically hackers bringing down servers, which makes it very difficult for us to do internet things. My name is Grant Rodiak. I'm the lead producer on The Sims 4. I work on the expansions, and I work on the game packs. This is Antonio Romeo. He was basically the head of festivals. He's going to be driving the stream today. I'm going to be over here on the chat answering your questions and being sarcastic as quickly as possible. Please forgive the chest hair. Let's do this.
All right, how's it going, guys? Today I have the Silver family. I have Kingston Silver, Raiden Silver, and then over here I have Lily Silver. And it looks like Raiden just got home from school and he's sort of winding down with his dad, letting some steam off with the brand new video game console. Looks like they're playing some SimCart style game here. So today I'm just going to, between Grant and I, we're just gonna answer some questions, play the game, go over some festivals if we can, and then just sort of have fun and try to answer as many things as you guys want. So let's go ahead and start. So one of the new objects I wanna bring light to that we really haven't covered is this new bulletin board. In every hallway of the apartments, you have this bulletin board that you can click on, and it'll actually tell you information about the festivals that are upcoming, and you can also leave sort of affirming notes for your next door neighbors. So let's go ahead and have Lily read about the festival.
Guys, that is rude talking about Antonio giving me his hair. Please don't make fun of my baldness. I work really hard for what I have.
Or lack thereof, that's fine. So we can see that this is the new panel. We have the Spice Festival coming up. This is the title of the festival up here. It has the location, which is the Waterside Marble, or Warble. And then the time, which is Friday, 5 p.m. to 1 a.m. So you can sort of prepare for it.
People are asking what apartment this is, Antonio.
I believe that, not Culpeper, this is the one next door to the Culpeper apartment. Let me,
go to build?
Yeah, let me enter build really quick.
It's Jasmine Suites, yeah.
Yep,
so Jasmine Suites. Spice District has Culpeper, which is my favorite place to live. It's all the really crappy apartments with leaky pipes and the junk. You'll get really familiar with the landlord. And then Jasmine Suites are a little bit higher up.
Yep. So let me go back into this because I had to enter build mode. So in addition to the festival name, time, and location, you have a little picture showing sort of a general piece of the festival, as well as some activities you can do. So you can enjoy local cuisine, you can participate in the spicy challenge, harvest fresh produce, and purchase unique spices from the swag stalls. So we see it starts at 5. The game here is at 4 o'clock. Almost 5. That was actually perfect timing. That might have been planned, maybe not. But you get a TNS up here in the corner, and again, you can just click that, and it brings you straight to the same dialogue.
Keep talking.
We're definitely trying to put this in front of you guys so you can easily access the festivals. Even while you're in the other worlds, like Windenburg or even the base game worlds, you'll get those TNSs telling you that a festival's in town. You can click it. And we have a handy button here that basically tells you, hey, this festival's happening. You can click it and then just travel straight to the festival. But luckily, we are in the location of the festival right now. So if we come outside here.
Before we go back, mm-hmm. Would it be possible to show some of the floors? Kieran Patton's been asking me the entire time to do some floors. We're going to show the floors, Kieran.
Let's do it.
I think he especially wants to see some of the crappy floors.
Okay. Let's enter build. So yeah, again, that's sort of what this stream is all about today, is just covering any questions you guys have while demonstrating some of the festivals.
Yeah, we're going to be kind of schizophrenic, jumping around like crazy.
Yeah. So the floors. Let's put on our pack filter here.
Pack filter.
City Living. Pack filter. So this is one of the new floors. It was funny, Delagrassi was here not too long ago, and she was sort of talking about how much she loved this new floor. We brought it in for the basketball court. So it's a sort of lacquer finish, very glossy hardwood floor, and it comes in a ton of different colors. So you can make like blue rooms, orange rooms, orange and blue rooms, or this lovely bright green color. So very colorful, and then you have your traditional like basketball court style floor here.
Somebody wants more talking things. We should make an entire suite of talking robot furniture.
Talking robot.
For those of you who don't know, we have a talking toilet in the game. It's sort of like HAL 9000 that you poop in. For those of you old enough to remember space.
So again, we have sort of covered a lot of this stuff in previous streams, but you guys may not have been watching then, so we'll sort of recap. So this is the talking toilet here. Before we do that, let me just show you how festivals look when they spin up, and then we can kind of go a little more freeform. So while we're here, I'm gonna just put it on speed 3. You can see that the open street area is dynamically changing, and stuff will start spawning in. Ooh. And you'll be able to just walk straight out into your open street and jump in the fun without even traveling, without even loading. I'm really excited about this.
This was one of the earliest things we prototyped, actually. I remember way back in the day, we just had like, what was it? It was like benches and like trees. We just had cherry blossom trees.
Bathrooms and toilets and sinks.
We just wanted to
sinks.
See if we could spawn stuff in and if we could change the world. And for those of you who are curious about how we actually make stuff, we actually, this is literally basically a second lot on top of the open street lot. And there's multiple configurations of these four different festivals and stuff. So we basically had to build different parts of the world multiple times. But what's great about this, and I really want to make this point, if you go back to your apartment, you could literally see this lot pop up, and you could just click downstairs, and there's no load time between your apartment and what's happening on the street. Something we really tried to do with this pack is we wanted that sense of living in the apartment feels really special and different from living in a residential house in, say, Willow Creek. But you could look outside your apartment, literally out to the window, and there's gameplay just out the window, because we wanted you to have stuff to do. And so it seems like a small deal, but it really makes a big difference, and we really try to make the street more lively.
Mm-hmm. So the other thing you'll notice sometimes out in the open street is we have these signs here, and they act similar to the bulletin board as well as the TNS. But when a festival is actually going on, this little VFX will pop up around that sign, and you can click it, and then you can go ahead and read about festival, and again, it pops you that same dialogue. So we're really trying to give you a couple different avenues to access these things. Another new object that we haven't really talked about much is the performance base. So if your sim has a guitar or violin in their inventory and they're at least level 4 or higher in the respective instrument, they can actually come out here and busk for money. This pack has a ton of different things to sort of make money on the side out in the open street, and not you don't actually need to get a job. So between busking as the statue, performing at the performance space, and you can sort of sell crafts with the craft sales stall and the open street gallery. There's a lot of ways to do that.
So a couple quick questions that we're seeing a lot of. People keep asking what a TNS is. TNS is sort of shorthand speak. TNS stands for text notification system. And if you look in the top right corner, your notification will
work. Our faces are
your
there
face
right now.
Is there.
But where are our faces? Oh, you can kind of see it.
I'll move it.
So yeah. where our faces are. Steve, move the panel.
Oh, basically below our faces are, that's what a TNS is. People keep asking about new Woohoo spot. There is not a new spot to Woohoo in this game. We wanted to make sure that when we do a Woohoo, it makes sense. We had a lot of funny options in Get Together, like the bush and the closet. In this pack, we didn't quite have a place that made sense, and it seemed a little bit awkward to go Woohoo in a stall. Like, if you think about that story-wise, you're sort of like, yes, I would like to buy your samosas. Those seem delicious. Also, my wife and I would like to partake of each other's company in your stall, if you could please leave your stall. And it just didn't quite make sense.
Yeah. So each festival is going to have a unique swag stall, and if you notice at the little modal dialogue that popped up, we talked about buying unique spices. So you can see here we have chili powder, curry, saffron, as well as wasabi, and you can go ahead and add these to various dishes and sort of spice up your cooking at home.
So people are noting on the color and stuff like that, and some of you are picking this up. We are very much inspired by Indian culture, Japanese culture, and Moroccan culture. With Get Together, we sort of look to Europe. We're a global game. You guys are all over the world. And with EP2, we try to look to Europe to try to make something that felt a little bit more like the homes that you're used to. And with City Living, we were inspired by Asian cities and Asian cultures to try to make something that appealed to another slice of our audience. So you're gonna see a lot of color, a lot of vibrancy, a lot of food that fit here. And you guys are keep asking about, did the elevator not make sense? The elevator didn't make sense because the elevator is not a build object. It's just something that you use to go up and downstairs. So you cannot woohoo in the elevator.
Yeah, so again, let me go ahead and buy some swag here. I'm gonna send little Raiden over because I saw some bubbles that I wanted to buy for him. So here, each festival is gonna have a unique set of fireworks, snow globes, as well as a little bubble bottle that kids can purchase. And this has different color bubbles that the kids can use while the other Sims are using the bubble blower. So, and then I'll switch over to Kingston, and we can buy some swag with him.
While you're doing this, can you explain for some of the folks how spices work? The spices that you buy here at the Spice Festival?
Yeah, so the spices you buy here, you can actually add them to your cooking at home, and it'll sort of add different moodlets or quality to the food when you cook with it. So we have the Freezer Bunny Snow Globe here that you can buy at the food festival. We also have the green fireworks, and that is special to the food festival as well. So I'll go ahead and buy some of these and possibly light them off, because I know some of you had questions about fireworks.
And when you're setting that up, people are also asking sort of like what the schedule and routine is for the festival, so we can talk to that.
Yeah, so as you saw in that dialogue, we have a general like vague schedule just so you can kind of plan sort of a day ahead with that bulletin board. But for the most part, festivals have a specific day they're set on, but depending on the week, like my game may be different from Grant's game. Like week one of my game, I may get the food festival and the Blossom Festival. And week one of Grant's game, he may get the GeekCon and potentially the flea market. So we have set times for them, but which ones show up depending on the week is sort of random. So with that, let me go ahead and light some sparklers here. So one of my favorite new interactions with the sparklers, you can actually click on kids and you can give them sparklers to create this really great like parent-child moment of lighting sparklers, and they can go ahead and, they can go ahead and play with sparklers, and I'm gonna go ahead and light one for Kingston as well.
So while you're playing with these, people are asking how many festivals are there, and we actually have quite a few. We have the Spice Festival, mm-hmm. Now you go.
We have Spice Festival, we have the Romance Festival.
Humor and Hijinks Festival.
Humor and Hijinks Festival, and then we also have GeekCon.
And the Flea Market.
Yep, so in total, 5 brand new festivals.
And we're the Wonder Festival. I'm sorry, we're really stupid, it's Friday.
Yeah, it's been a long week.
So people are asking to see the new traits. Did we set up any of these basic sims with the new traits?
No, but we can bring...
Do we have a cheat build?
So We have a cheat build.
The new traits are on Flirty, which is sort of like the opposite of Flirty. They're kind of like romantically shy. They're a little less inclined. They have awkward hugs and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. The other one is vegetarian. It made sense that if we're going to do things like Indian food, it's a culture that's all about vegetarianism and so many slices of their country and their culture. It only made sense to have vegetarian. It's also something we've wanted to do for a while because a lot of people really identify themselves as vegetarians. And so it's kind of difficult to show these in the stream because basically a vegetarian prefers to eat certain foods and they get sick if they eat foods they don't like. Mm-hmm. So it's not really something that we could show very easily. But yes, we have those two new traits, but we also have some secret traits, don't we?
Yeah, so one of those is actually the Spice Hound. When you participate in the Spicy Challenge at the Food Festival where we're at right now, if you participate in this and complete it, you get a hidden trait, which is right here, and you can also get a new social where you can brag about being the Spicy Curry Championship, or the champion. And you can also get a brand new shirt. So let's see if we can get Kingston to complete this challenge. I'll also send Raiden over here to see if he has what it takes to be the Spice Challenge champion.
Folks are asking about the earthquake. So the earthquake basically shakes your screen. It creates this big moment. Your Sims freak out and they get moodlets about it. Mm-hmm. Which is basically what happens in real life. For those of us who live in the Bay Area, they are terrifying. One of the scariest moments of my life. Laura Locke, you say, hey, reply to me though. I don't know what you want me to reply to you. So I'm just going to say, hey, Laura Locke, I'm replying to you.
So we can see here that Kingston is powering through this curry and he finished it, and Raiden is not doing so well. He had sort of the food fail. And Kingston, for completing it, he gets this cool new t-shirt. My other favorite thing that we have too is when you fail, your bladder actually tanks and you're gonna have to go to the restroom real fast. So this is the new Spice Festival t-shirt you get for completing the Spicy Curry Challenge. It's a nice little hot pepper.
We do have a new aspiration map train guy. Is it the City Native aspiration? Is that what the final name was?
Yeah, so we can actually open this.
Yeah, so the City Native aspiration is something really great. It's kind of modeled after the outdoors aspiration that we did for Outdoor Retreat, which is basically it guides you through all the great cool stuff in the city, and it sort of shows off a lot of the ways. Like if you first get city living and you want to sort of find out what all the cool stuff is, change to the City Native trait. And the reward bonus, isn't it basically that like when you're in your neighborhood, you get a bonus because you're happier in your home neighborhood?
Yeah, I can't really remember the final bonus, yeah. But I know Rebecca is.
So we sound like idiots. The game is so big that it's like literally hard to, like we can't remember all of all the details, and I don't want to lie to you guys. They're asking about new deaths. What's the new death, Antonio?
Oh, the new death is hilarious. Definitely my favorite. We even have a brand new ghost type for it. I won't spoil it. I'll let you find it. But the new death, if you have some poor quality pufferfish, there's a chance your sim can die, and you will find out that there's a new ghost type and a new death type
and
with it.
This, if you've been waiting to get dine out, oh, tell them about the bulletin board while you're
there.
I'll start up then. If you've been waiting to get dine out, you need to get dine out plus city living, because you can make a restaurant that serves nothing but low quality puffer fish.
A death restaurant.
You can basically make a murder restaurant.
Yes.
It's been something that's been amusing us for a while now.
Yeah, we saw a couple people are wearing this unique t-shirt too. So that's the festival t-shirt that you can buy.
One quick public service announcement. You guys ask a lot, and I understand why. I totally get it. You ask a lot about new content, future content, things that you want to see. I cannot comment on anything. I literally can't. I would lose my job. Antonio would lose his job. We can't talk about new stuff. So if it's not in the game yet, if it's not already out, we cannot talk about it. I'm sorry.
So here we have a bubble blower, and this is one of our new cultural objects where when Sims see it for the first time, they kind of do like an angry, what is this thing? And it's a pretty funny moment. But this thing has a ton of new flavors. I know Jeff Mitchell and the producer on this, who was it? I think it was Rebecca.
I think it was Rebecca.
Yeah.
Rebecca's one of our newest team members. She's great.
They had a ton of fun creating flavors for this. So we have Cosmic Encounter, Deepest Plum, Fairy Fizz, and then Snow Flurry, which is great for when you finish eating the spicy curry. You can come here and cool out with that new flavor.
Real quick, we got a special quest.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday, Brittany!
This is like the worst radio show ever. Coming in on the twos.
All right, we're gonna go ahead and jump over to stalls a little more. Let's see what food we have here. So you can come over to this stall, and the food festival or the spice festival has the most carts at one festival.
Are we okay, Steve? It's showing us looping here.
Oh no! Did we lose stream?
Yeah, it looks like crap for us.
Okay. Great, good.
Internet's bad for us, but everybody else says that they're doing great. So.
Yay, we're struggling with internet here at EA, but let's hope you guys are doing fine. So here we have the Mexican cart that has burritos, empanadas. We have a ramen cart, and we also have a spicy curry cart. So let's go ahead and go over to this Mexican cart here. And yes, for those of you who are curious, I sent a tweet out about this earlier, but all the brand new recipes can be used in the restaurant pack if you guys have both. So the chicken burrito is $12, it's a little expensive. So I'm gonna see if I can haggle her down to get a better price.
Breezy, we don't have new woohoos. Guys, we don't have a new woohoo in this pack. You got two in the last pack, it averages out. You guys are dirty, dirty people.
Eliza Pancakes drives a hard bargain, so she's not gonna budge on price, but we'll go ahead and buy it anyways. I'm gonna buy a chicken burrito here. All right. She pulls it out.
The stalls are only run by the NPCs, Baked Zinger. You guys have weird names.
So we have, how many recipes do we have in the new pack? Actually, let's check really quick.
It's like 22 or something.
I think we have. So we have new snow globes. We have 15 snow globes.
Yay, snow globes.
I think there might be.
What's cool about the recipes is you can learn them, like you learn to cook them when you go try them in the food. Yeah, you can haggle, Ronica. We absolutely did not make a street vendor that you can't haggle with. Otherwise, what are we, monsters?
So we also have, in addition to snow globes, we also have city posters that you can walk around and find in the city.
Do you remember if charisma was tied into the haggle?
Based off your charisma skill or any sort of negotiating, it's all tied into your charisma skill. So let me hurry up and finish this chicken burrito. And I wanted to show off some of the new. So, Steve, did you move this? Yes, you moved it.
Do you want to move?
No, you're good. All right. So the new TNS pops up here. It says Kingston has learned how to make chicken burritos. So far, Kingston has discovered 2 of the 27 recipes available in the city. So we have 27 brand new recipes, and once you fully eat a plate of that recipe, you will learn how to cook it, and then you can just go back home. Let's see if I can do it.
Did the slow globes move inside? Can you place one down?
Oh yeah.
Don't they have like little effects that move?
It's in the middle.
Well, hold on.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm trying to like. I'm trying to jump Antonio out of his flow.
So we have the new recipe pops up here, and also because Kingston is a a curry champion. He knows how to make curry as well as the chicken burrito that he just finished. So, what were you asking? The snow globe?
Snow globe. Can you put it down on the ground just so people can see that snow globe?
Yes. Let's go ahead.
Yes, fireworks can start fires. Like, dear God, of course they can start fires. And if you put them indoors, don't they always start fires?
Yes. If you light a firework inside, it is guaranteed it will explode. And your sim will not be happy. So here's our little freezer bunny snow globe.
Shut your mouth.
They all have unique little VFX in them.
Freezer bunny, yay!
We have a dinosaur one. We have... the dinosaur one has like meteors coming down from the sky and a bunch of different ones. I think we have one. There should be one for each festival. Let's go ahead and light some fireworks since you guys are talking about that. We'll light one inside.
Show them how they chain. Let's not show them inside in case we need to go back to that house for something.
Yeah, sure. We don't want to light the whole house. Because we're on a dev build, I'm cheating. My sim. Oh no, I don't have that cheat.
No, that's fine. You have the release build.
That's okay.
No, you're not a release. It's so hard to play the game.
Okay, here. Let's go ahead and place these in the world.
So, fun fact about the freezer bunny, I personally despise it and try to keep it out of our game as much as possible.
But somehow it finds a way in there.
It always shows up, stupid freezer bunny.
The sneaky modeling team. They always find ways to do it. It might be Jill. Jill has an obsession with that freezer bunny. So you can go ahead and place all these in the world, and instead of going around one by one and lighting them...
They chain.
Yeah, they'll chain together, so you basically light one. So let's go ahead and light this one.
So, and we're going to have to zoom up to show the picture.
Yeah. So let's light one.
Midnight, the stream started about 10 minutes ago. We started a little bit late. Oh god.
And they basically chain into each other.
Woo! Look, there's our new raccoon suit.
Oh, the raccoon guy's here.
Yeah,
nice.
So we have a new weirdo that walks around the world. We call him the trash panda.
Yes.
He's just a creeper and a raccoon.
This guy.
I have to admit, the bear suit is my favorite thing. I've been working on The Sims for 11 years now. The bear suit is literally my favorite thing that we have ever done.
What?
What I love about the suits, no matter what emotion they're in, their eyes are so dead and lifeless. They could be sad, they could be happy. This cracks.
All right, enjoy the screenshots. Just take there.
Hey, game only. There you go.
Great. We'll just sit in here for a little bit. Okay, we're good.
A little chat.
Grant's done. He's enjoyed
I'll
that.
I'll see you guys later. I'm sitting here crying.
Okay, so my sim just failed at lighting fireworks, so you get this little bar.
Is he a chicken?
What?
Is he a chicken?
He's doing the chicken dance. Look at that. It's chicken dance. I don't know. All right. And goodbye, Grant. He's done.
Slayed over there.
So we may have shown this a couple times, but we're gonna go ahead and show the bidet show here. Let's turn it back on. Control panel.
Yeah, let's get to
special
better
effects.
Humor with the bidet show.
Bidet show on.
Oh, this talking toilet is so good.
It's very good.
It's my favorite stupid joke in this book.
My favorite thing to do is to talk smack to the talking toilet and then immediately turn around and use it.
So. Around the time we hit Alpha is where we have all the features are in, but usually they don't work very well yet, but basically all the stuff is checked in. And we usually do extensive playtesting at that time with, we have Sims fans come in and play, we have random people come in and play, we have like professionals come in and play, like reviewers and stuff to give us their professional feedback. And one of my favorite quotes that we have ever had in playtesting in my life is one of them was playing and he goes, "You know, the talking toilet was my best friend." which I just wasn't expecting at all.
Yeah, it's very good. So that is just about everything for the Spice Festival. Oh, Kingston really had to use the restroom. He was in there.
Yes.
I don't want to go spy on him. And the festival, just like that, as quickly as it's set up and sort of started, it just tore down. And now you have everyone sort of hanging out, enjoying the last of their food before they go home. Sometimes Sims will go ahead and filter back into the bars and just fill out the rest of the area depending on where you're at. And now we can see a brand new layer popped up with a
different cart.
Yeah,
different
curry
food.
Cart and a tea cart. You can just come down here, enjoy some midnight tea.
Something we really try to prioritize in the city is to make the streets feel, that poor guy, make the streets feel a little more lively. Oh, and you've got a box over here. Is that we actually wanted to have a lot of gameplay on the street. We wanted to have a lot of characters on the street. And so you could look out your window in the Spice District and you could see people painting murals, you could see people playing basketball, you could see people protesting, you can go down there and put up a speech, you can go down there and set up a painting cart to sell paintings that you make, you can busk with the new rug that you put down. There's so much gameplay just outside your window. We really wanted people to leave their home and not just be stuck inside. That guy's jamming, man.
I love that sweater. And the pants. Look at these two-tone. They're like two-faced pants.
Yeah, I don't even, like, are those like male stretch pants?
He's getting it done. It's fine.
Yoga pants?
Let's see. Does anyone have any other questions?
Do you want to go show off some of the build objects just for a
bit?
Sure. Then we'll move on maybe to a different festival?
You know what? Let me actually, because the best way to show off build objects is to go to an open lot. Because then we can just place whatever we want.
Bolette Podgkin 2, you said, what should I study if I want to work on The Sims? So the number one thing I would always recommend is computer science, the ability to code, program. That's basically the number one way to make games, period. Steve gives us a thumbs up. Finally, Steve and I agree on something. There's also the art disciplines. If you have a strong art portfolio, animation, modeling, concept, we do all of those things as well. Being a producer or designer is, it's a lot weirder. And we have such like, Antonio studied economics.
Yeah.
Lindsay went to art school. I studied international business. Dave probably studied taxidermy or something.
Is that why he's so good?
I think Gibson studied communications. And so like a lot of those things are just like very different. And it's really hard, but like study coding and like honestly be good at something, be passionate about it, love games, and it's sort of like getting, you know, lucky, right time, right place.
So some of you guys asked, they mentioned about beds. So let's go ahead and show all objects. So this is all the new stuff for City Living. One of my favorite beds that we have now. We finally have a high-end bed that is not like the Victorian gaudy bed. So you like, for those of you modern builders who like to build modern houses, this is a nice little fit. It's the Cobra Cabana bed. And we also have the double futon. This bed I'm actually pretty stoked about. We have, let's see the different color variants. So we have just a straight black, little white, reds, blue. I like this little yellow and maroon color here. It's pretty nice. We have very similar color palettes with this bed as well. Oh, this bed, orange and blue, favorite colors. And then we have a smaller version. That looks very comfy. It's like a little space blanket on that. And we have some different chairs. Oh, my favorite chair in all of Sims 4 is this. This is Foldy, the foldable metal chair. You will see some billboards around the world with him on it. We've sort of built a backstory for this simple yet complex foldable chair.
And before you go, can we see if we have any plants here? We've got the Simply Nando asking for new plants. Nando's big into plants.
Let's see, what plants
do we
have?
We always build plants.
I think Jill and I showed off a couple last time.
New plants?
Yeah, I saw it. It's somewhere. It's a little cart.
Would they be outside?
No, it's a. We have this. We have like little planter boxes.
Nice. Sort of an Indian motif. We've got that right there.
Yeah, here it is. I hit the plant jackpot.
And we've got that.
I'm showing off color variants.
So many plants.
There's all the color variants. I could spend hours just looking at objects in build mode. This is really cool. So, thing I love to do with this is to size this puppy up. And you can sort of place it in center squares of your lots.
Can you turn the grid off? People are yelling at us. Stop being so shouty, Sims fans. Jeez.
Look at my deliberate use of hotkeys.
Oh, hotkeys! Hashtag hotkeys.
Hot teas?
Hot teas. I didn't know we were talking about the Humor and Hygiene Festival.
Hot teas. So this is that. Why does my escape button not work?
Kieran, yes, we have two new TV channels.
You didn't escape?
Yeah. Is it one new TV channel or two new?
We have one new TV channel.
Political?
There's a political one. Political? I think there's a cultural station as well.
It's a political and cultural station. We also have a crap ton of new videos for the karaoke. It's like 20 plus videos.
So my escape button isn't working, so deleting
what?
Is fun.
Oh.
I blame Steve. It's always Steve's fault.
I'm just going to hit escape.
If you blame Steve for everything.
Escape doesn't work, dude. It's fine.
You sure?
It's all good.
You sure?
It's okay.
Okay.
Sure. So we have this little potted plant with like modern. What do you call these? What are these like?
I have no clue what that. Oh, those are succulents.
Succulents. Yeah. See, I knew you know.
Good job.
And we have this one's my favorite. I like this. This like lovely rose thing.
So butter up for your dean. The styles were all inspired by Indian culture, Moroccan culture, and Japanese culture. We love the colors, the patterns. The sights, the smells, the food of those different groups, and so those heavily inspired what we made. So when we visit GeekCon and stream, that is the plan, right?
Yeah, the hope is to.
It depends on where we go, Finkelton. This has gone off the rails.
Yeah. So with Grant and I doing streams, you usually can't keep us on rails. We find a way to get off. So this is the new podium object. You can come up here, give speeches, practice speeches. You can, I believe you can put this in your inventory and bring it out into the world. We've also have some set up in different districts for you to practice speeches and promote the career.
So Brightastic is asking about Native American culture, Native American, Indigenous, Aboriginal, Indian, all the different names. That's definitely something that we'd actually really like to do, and we're trying to hit on different cultures. We're looking at West Indian culture and things like that, like the Caribbean. It's one of those things that we have to be very careful to be appropriate and fair and make sure that we're presenting people correctly. And it's something that we never, ever, ever want to hurt or offend someone with how we make things. So it's something we'd like to do. We're really trying to reach out and represent just all the color and diversity that we have from our user base all over the world. So it's something we'd like to do, and we're trying to figure it out how to do all those things.
So people are talking, a lot of people are talking about culture, and this pack just has a ton of different paintings to sort of bring out the cultural influences here. So I think for any pack, those of you who like paintings and decorating your houses with paintings, this is the pack for you.
Hey, Junabelle, you're asking, the fireworks, if you get married in Myshuno Meadows, which is the new park, if you get married there in the official wedding ceremony, the fireworks do go off.
We actually built the tech into the wedding arch itself, so when you place the wedding arch...
If you place fireworks anywhere in the world,
yep.
Even better. You guys are geniuses.
Yeah, so if fireworks are nearby and you get married, even the... We found out that the renew vows also work. So when you get married or renew your vows in the wedding arch and there's fireworks within a close radius, they'll all just trigger automatically.
I've got two or three people shouting us about wallpapers.
Wallpapers.
I gotta tell you guys, when I was 22 years old, I never thought that I would have thousands of people shouting at me about wallpapers.
Wallpapers? So here's some wallpapers.
You guys are weird.
Our escape button doesn't work. We cannot escape. So we have a whole new suite of grungy objects, which I know people have been asking for. So we have like kind of trashed counters. We have both variants. I think we also have some. Let's see. What else do we have? We have trash counters. We have like a trash fridge, couches. We have some sort of grungy wallpaper, and I think we have what else? Some floor. We may have some floors that are also pretty grungy.
What was cool about this is this is a perfect case of how we change the game after we start it. So again, around Alpha or so, we're playing, and we were just playing with the crappy low-level apartments. And one thing we noticed is that they didn't really feel that crappy. Like when I first moved to San Francisco, I lived in a basement for $500 a month, and I had no drywall, no air conditioning, and I lived in a garage with like, and there was like 8 other people in the house. It was awful. And then I moved into another apartment that flooded every day. And I know crappy apartments, and our apartments were actually quite nice. And our art team was like, cool, we'll whip something up. And they made these just nasty, grungy, lived-in apartments, and it makes such a difference.
Yeah, another sculpture we have here that I really like is this sort of paper swan. This is actually a light. We have it in the fashion district, but you can place it on your lot and it'll illuminate sort of the surrounding objects and area. What else do we have? Oh, this...
Wallpapers.
I think I showed them wallpapers.
You just did the grungy one.
Let's see.
They're demanding wallpapers, Antonio.
All the wallpapers. All right, more wallpapers. So we have some new brick. We have some line ones. Do we have... So I think this is part of the grungy one because you have like little dirt.
Yeah, you got the dirt on the bottom.
On the bottom. We have some brick, some new brick options here. I like this full black one. Oh, it's sort of like a purpley. And then this is sort of like a brushed metal wallpaper. We have our normal brick stone.
Hi, Kieran. We're only focusing on the new wallpapers.
And then we also have more brick, all the brick, and then these two I showed you already.
So while we're going, let's transition to some more gameplay now. Mm-hmm. Let's give those live mode players their fix. Can you talk a little bit about the flea market here for folks who are asking? Mini Munch 04 is asking about the flea market, which is one of my favorite places.
Let's see if I have cheats. Maybe I might be able to cheat it in.
While he's doing this, I'll give you the idea. So the flea market is all about buying random junk. You can find unique stuff that you literally cannot buy anywhere else. It's a great place to trade collectibles. So if you're trying to get that last piece of your collection, it's a great place to trade collectibles. It's also, one of my favorite objects in the game is that inspired by France, actually Paris, where along the River Seine they have the people who sell paintings and stuff. We wanted to have the ability to sell paintings out on the street if you're an artist, or the ability to sell other junk and tchotchkes. And so we created these stalls where you can place them out in the world and sell stuff. And it's perfect at the flea market and things like that. Smiley180, you're asking how are warehouses different from regular houses? It's sort of a warehouse fictionally. It's not like functionally different than a warehouse. Jill the florist, hey, florists are great. You said, can we see Cass? We should definitely go to Cass before we...
You know what, let's...
You want to go now?
Sure, really quickly though, before we jump into Cass. Grant was briefly talking about the craft sale stalls. So you have a table where you can sell collectibles, and then we also have a street gallery where you can put this in your inventory, bring out paintings, and sell paintings in the open street as well.
You cannot knock down external walls in an apartment, map train guy.
Just do this.
You cannot change external walls, but you can change all the internal ones. So you can't piss off the landlord because you can't do it. Butter up for your bean. Elevators are not a build mode object. They are purely based on the shells themselves.
Plan outfits?
The elevator is not in show hidden objects. It's a build mode only construct.
So when you're in penthouses, you'll actually have the ability to place elevators.
So you can actually place them in build mode in penthouses. Yeah, but not in normal apartments.
So here are the...
Yeah, let's quickly... We're going to quickly go through this, then we'll go back to the festivals.
Let's go city living. So here's all the new stuff we have for males.
Crystal to City, we're gonna go through the, we're gonna show off one more festival after we do Cass really quickly.
Yeah, so like Grant was mentioning, we have a lot of culturally inspired assets. Some kimonos, lovely kimonos. Here, let's go.
Give the poor guy some normal pants.
Let's go this side. No, it's fine. He can hang out in those pants. We have like a lot of mesh and very like this is sort of the middle, like,
go to that one. I love
this one.
So this is a really great idea of something that's sort of inspired by sort of a classic cultural thing, but then we've sort of fused it to make it something more, a little more everyday. We're gonna go to GeekCon, guys. Please we know we're gonna go there. Just we're going through a lot of stuff.
This is the business casual tuxedo that I really like. This colorful,
nice.
Here's that shirt I unlocked. You can equip it in Cass. So that's sort of a brief overview of new cast stuff. You want to go ahead and just jump to the festival?
Quickly go show some of the male clothing after we show some of the female clothing and then...
This is really cool. This little...
Yeah, show a quick smattering of stuff and then we'll just quickly show some dude stuff. Because we got people yelling at us about festivals.
All the things. We're trying to cram as much as we can in the stream.
Oh, what are those? What is that?
This little loincloth?
Yes! somebody's been asking about tattoos. Do we have new tattoos with...
Let me see, actually. I'll check. Where are these accessories?
I don't use the tattoos in game.
I don't, actually. Stop, no. I'm pretty sure it's accessories, right?
No. Where the hell are they?
It's... Oh my gosh. It should be here. Yeah, oh, these are the tattoos. I was waiting for this. We actually do have new tattoos. So we have this, that one, this nice little tribal looking one. Koi fish.
So Lilla Builds, you say, Grant, are you back with The Sims? I've been back with The Sims for 5 years now. I've been at The Sims for 10 of the 11 years I've been in the industry.
Forever, we can't get rid of them.
They try to fire me, but I refuse to leave.
Let's, just because we can, let's go ahead and throw on.
Just so we're clear right now, Amanda Drake is typing, not me, so if she says something crazy, it's not my fault.
There we go.
Yes! Guys, what?
Hold on. We gotta put her in the panda suit, too.
Min Munch on 4, we won't be going to flea markets today, that's not the plan. We're gonna go to GeekCon after we leave Cass.
Yep. Let's do the color panda. This one, yay! Let's break green.
Con HP. We're gonna go to festival shortly. We're trying to give people a lot of different stuff. It's gonna be cool. Trust me. We're gonna go back to live mode.
All right, we're going right now. We will head over to GeekCon and check that out. While we load, you guys are launching questions at us very fast. Grant's doing a pretty good job right now answering.
I've been back for 5 years, aesthetic Rob. Like, you say, Greg, come back. I've been back. What do you want?
Let's go ahead next to me, man.
I will pass the blame on Amanda as much as I can.
And Steve.
Oh, I thought I snuck out of that one.
Go, Steve. Steve, you're the one we're gonna target.
So because festivals are sort of random and on different schedules, I've made two saves. So I'm loading into my second save right now.
So this person said, will we get aliens to abduct apartments? That doesn't even make sense, dude. What?
It will abduct the entire apartment.
What alien fiction are you reading, man?
Cows.
God, now we have people yelling us to go back to build mode. I can't win.
No, it's not gonna happen. Can't win. We're going back on the rails. That's it. We tried to go off rails and people are yelling at us.
Come back to typing to people, Catherine. Why are you shouting all caps is very rude in the modern century.
Okay, so we have this dynamic sign here. We're going to go ahead and read about this festival. Again, GeekCon. It happens at Planet Honey Pop, which is the resident karaoke location for Fashion District. And it happens on Tuesdays from 10 to 4. I don't know what just happened, but Grant is cracking up.
Cinderella Mouse put hashtag blame Steve, and I also follow.
I don't know which one it is. Yeah. I don't know whether it's Amanda or Grant.
Hashtag blame Steve. So we have a hackathon. We have the ultimate gaming test. You can also improve skill gain here. So while you're at GeekCon, you'll improve programming, rocket skill, gaming skill, and there's one more, logic skill. You'll improve all of those at an increased rate. So if you even come here with a club that is set up to increase those faster as well, you'll get, it'll all stack.
I just want to thank all of you for joining me on hashtag blame Steve. This is very important. No. Please go find him on Twitter and respond to him with hashtag blame Steve.
Yeah. So I'll go ahead and speed this up and then we'll have, so the festival's
in town now. 8601, try to stop trying to make fetch happen.
So we can see the festival coming in. At this festival, we have one rocket that's set up, already built. If you are lucky enough, there's a rare chance that rocket ship woohooers will show up and they'll jump in this rocket and go ahead and blast off. And you can jump on the computers at GeekCon and listen in on them woohooing in space. So this is the new swag stall. So I don't know.
Blame Steve, blame Steve, blame Steve.
It sounds like the hashtag is picking up speed. So we have an Emily snow globe. Those of you who own Get Together may know Emily. She's the resident sea monster in the Cliffside Bluffs. So we have a little snow globe to commemorate her, and you can only get that at GeekCon. We have some purple bubbles and a suite of purple fireworks.
Can you zoom out real quick just to give them a little more look at GeekCon? Because this is one of the first festivals that I think like really like. Festivals are really difficult to develop. They're really difficult to design. We've never quite done something exactly like them. And I think this is one of the first ones where like the promise, the visuals, it all really came together. And we're like, oh man, that's great.
Yeah, we have cosplayers that'll show up. So we have Llama Man here hanging out. We have an Oracle. We have Princess Leia hanging out here. We also have the Reaper and some plumber that may look oddly familiar in a green jumpsuit.
Is he Italian?
I don't know, he's like a blonde Italian, it's very rare.
I don't know if you guys know this, but Antonio is intensely Italian.
Intensely?
He represents our American Italian brand.
Yuji is more Italian than I am, but
he's like literally both country, his passport says Italian.
Yes. Italian. So you get a new interaction too. You can take pictures with cosplayers, you can take a selfie.
What's great is, did you see that tourist in the background there?
The tourist. Oh yeah, this guy. The girl, fanny pack. Lad. Yeah, she's rocking the fanny pack and a lovely Hawaiian t-shirt. Oh, socks with sandals!
Boo!
Yeah!
Boo!
That's great. So again, you guys saw some of the unique stuff at this festival. So what this festival is known for is for hackathon and the ultimate gaming contest. So when those actually start, the computer and this motion gaming rig will get that orange glow on them, telling you that the festivals are actually, or the contests are actually active. So you can come over here and play the ultimate gaming test. So we'll go ahead and do that really fast. So we'll send Kingston in here.
No 8-bit dome, we don't have con crud from the con.
No con crud. So what I like about this interaction is it will cycle through all the various games of the ultimate or the gaming mat, and your sim will be scored on how well they are at playing those games.
Really quickly, I just want to call attention to the absurdity of our game. We have this really slick Jake Gyllenhaal looking dude playing in a video game competition while we have Man Bun Space Ranger in the background.
It's not a man bun.
It's a man bun.
He's got like the little.
That is a man bun.
He turned.
Hashtag blame man bun.
Hashtag blame man bun. So I'm going to go ahead and send Lily over. Oh no, all the computers are taken.
I like that the human statue's playing.
It's just like. He's like, hold on. This needs to happen. So I'm going to participate in Hackathon here.
Hackathon!
See if I can kick him out.
Hacking away!
So Kingston Silver just completed the ultimate gaming test. I got a score of 70, so we can see Refuge score was 14 out of 20. Blick Block was 21 out of 30. Here's my various scores. He won 100 simoleons and a future cube. And then they also say, we have plenty more cubes to give away, so make sure to come back again soon.
Hashtag blame man bun. So, Map Train Guy, you're asking how often are the festivals? There's usually, two or three per week?
Yeah, so it'll range from two to three per week, depending on your game. And again, like I said, it's sort of random which ones show up per week. But we at least guarantee that you'll get at least two, three per week.
Mrs. Tomato noticed that the future cube is the prize, which is our that is sort of our self-deprecating joke on how crappy the future cube is.
Woo! Look at that. But you get 100 simoleons, but to add insult to injury, the future cube sells for 325 simoleons. Oh. So if you just sell that future cube off, you get a nice $425 game.
So,
how long do the festivals last?
Generally, they last around 8 hours. Some festivals are shorter than others, just to make sure you kind of jump around and you can. We wanted to tune it so you can sort of juggle different things at once. So, GeekCon, I think, is 6, and Humor and Hijinks is 6 as well, but all the other ones are 8.
Hey, Finkleton, we're not talking about Void Critters because that's a part of one of the stuff packs. And we're focused today on. I can't remember all the
City
names.
City Living.
Fun thing, I always say Great Outdoors for Outdoor Retreat because it used to be called Great Outdoors at some point, and I'll be at all these press conferences. I'm like, well, with Great Outdoors, crap. So it's just one of those things. We're focused on City Living today, so sorry.
So we're going to go ahead and woohoo in space with Kingston and Lily. So it's nice. We found out that a lot of our players actually haven't completed the rocket. So one thing we wanted to include in this festival was a fully built rocket that you can actually come and hang out.
Yeah, it's a really fun object that a lot of people haven't really messed with. I don't know if you guys know this, but when people are woohooing, when people are in space, you can listen to the radio to listen to the space launch, and can't you listen to them if they're woohooing?
Yes, you can listen to woohoo in space, but we're going to have, I don't know, this is, Raiden is going to listen on his parents woohooing in space. I don't know if he should do that.
That's awful. He's going to learn a lot about life. guys, we do not have a new woohoo spot in City Living.
Yes.
We have all the greatest hits, though. If you want to have a new woohoo spot, for example, consider Outdoor Retreat with the tent, or Get Together with the bush. The closet. There's so many ways to woohoo with our fine array of products.
Yes. it looks like Lily actually won the hack contest, so she won an immersive Ben computer, and again, we pay out some simoleons. So this computer, I think, is 3,000 simoleons, so it's a nice little
reward. It's not too bad.
Let's see, let's enter game.
Are we any good at video games? Do you have any skills?
Lily is my super sim, so I've kind of been playing with this sim ever since base game. I've been sending her across all my other packs, so she is my super sim.
Can you, I would love to show them the new adventure game video because it's amazing.
Yeah.
And it also that TV is so big that they can even see it through the stream.
50 Mile High Club. Woo! All right, let's go ahead and come over here and play games with.
Annabelle 22, I'd appreciate it if you don't call out my hypocrisy.
you want the Genie Curse together?
Yeah, that's such a good game.
The Genie Curse.
So we have this incredible video team, as you guys see, that they make our video spots. And we're going to show you the video from the new video game where they used World Adventures from The Sims 3, as you can see, to make this crazy, crazy... If you guys remember Sega Genesis, this reminds me of the Aladdin video game.
Prince of Persia,
the original Prince of Persia. I love this, it's so great.
Yeah, the video team went a little nutso on our pack.
They went crazy.
All the karaoke videos, they created a whole new gaming system video, they created a couple new TV stations.
They say Grant is on the left and Antonio's on the right. Grant is in the red shirt.
Grant's red.
Grant's on the camera.
Yeah.
I don't understand physics.
Left and right.
Physics, he might not understand. He also doesn't understand his left from his right.
We're getting to the boss fight. We're getting to the boss fight. Jump over that, jump over that, jump over that.
I want to play this.
World Adventures was like the hardest pack to make ever.
Yeah.
I will never want to make World Adventures. That was so hard.
All the tomb designs, that should have been fun.
No! Boss fight!
Throw gems!
Yes! Get them!
Those are clearly gems. Those are not potions.
Look, dude.
High score. I think, don't we have like a Mass Effect?
Oh, the Mass Effect is hilarious.
Let's see. Let's see if I can change games here. Let's play games.
So just Alan, when your Sim's better at video games, when they develop their gaming skill, they unlock new games that they can play.
This is Density Effect.
Density Effect. I did not know that was in there.
Yes. This is our Mass Effect tribute game. All right.
So
oh yeah, you have your little...
I was just asked, how many gigabytes will be The Sims 4 City Living to download? I have literally no.
Steve, do you know?
It's probably like 2.5 gigs.
2.5?
2.5.
We're going to go with...
Quote unquote Steve.
We're going to go with 2.5
pretty sure.
And if Steve's wrong,
hashtag blame Steve.
Hashtag blame Steve.
Yes. Also, you can throw on the hashtag blame Amanda too if you want, but that's fine.
But mostly hashtag blame Steve. We hashtag blame Steve more than we hashtag
blame Amanda.
Blame
We should start a poll. I'm gonna make a Twitter post and have them vote.
Just
on,
a poll.
Yeah,
just
have
a poll. Hashtag
a poll.
Blame Steve.
Or hashtag.
No, it should be hashtag blame Amanda. Steve. Hashtag blame Drake. Hashtag fire Grant.
Yes. Fire Grant will probably win.
I know.
Somehow I escaped.
Where's
he from?
Are we even paying you? Why are you here?
why are you here?
I just love The Sims.
He loves playing. So it looks like the festival is actually gonna start closing down now.
Simi Bro, yeah. The new death type in The Sims 4 City Living is due to the pufferfish badly made.
Don't give anything away, though.
Nothing else.
Nothing else. It is a great little Easter egg that I want you guys to find out.
Voltron Games, how come there aren't limited edition for EPs? The problem is that often basically we have to spend, we would have to find the resources to make more stuff for the special edition or take it away from the normal edition. Like it's just tougher. Like where everything costs time and money and people and we have limited resources. Can we just, in speed one, can we look at the city out here? Like, so if you guys, something I think is just incredible, it's such a huge step forward for our art team. I just want you to look at like the sheer vibrancy of this city. You have Sims all over the world. You've got real traffic, you've got lights. Yes, I think, can aliens abduct Sims in apartments? I think they can.
Yes, Sims will route outside.
Sims can be abducted in their apartment. But like, just like, look at this city. Like, go load up Late Night from Sims 3 and then look at this screenshot. And it's just sort of like, why the hell would you ever play Late Night again? Like, I am so proud of what this team accomplished on this pack. It looks so good.
Yeah.
Like, our goal was, we looked at Late Night and we said, we could do this so much better. And we did. And like, this is, I'm so proud of the team. This is so amazing.
Yeah, if you want more of the world stuff, definitely check out our Jill and I's Twitch stream. We basically covered all the neighborhoods and gushed about how well our environment team did. They knocked it out of the park
on
this.
So one thing, Lux Sims, you referenced BART. Unlike BART, loading actually works on time in our game.
Yes.
That is a Bay Area mass transit joke, which is only funny to two of you on the stream.
It'll always be on time here.
Hey, I can't say your name. Kitten person, I cannot talk about future content, potential future content. I just can't talk about it, so you can't ask. I won't be able to say anything. Why is there no new life state in City Living? Millic Hippie, it didn't quite make sense. We wanted to focus on the city, and we didn't feel like a new life state made sense for the city. Can you have giveaways on City Living? We don't really have giveaways, but we have contests and things that you can win and all sorts of stuff that you can unlock and discover in the city.
I think they mean like giveaways as in...
That's a marketing problem.
Hashtag blame Drake.
Somebody...
giving away the actual...
Oh, pack. You want to get a free game. I don't know about... You cannot use the trains. It didn't quite make sense to do all the work to make you use a train, which is literally just a new place to click for the loading screen we already have. Tourists don't live in the city, they're tourists that randomly come out and come see the city. Can we see the world icon in the world menu, please? Antonio, let's see the world icon in the world menu, please. How many new families are there in the city? I think it's like 6 or 7 pre-made families.
Yeah, I think so. We can actually
look. It's about 6 or 7.
We can look right now. So we have the starting household. This is Culpepper. So we have
the Masoya.
Yeah.
I love them. It's a guy who lives with, is he lives with his mom?
I'm not sure. Jill is the expert on our pre-maids.
Oh, no, yeah, I think he lives with his mom.
Pre-maids.
Jill's the world lady.
Yeah.
Manali, he's super cool.
We have, I'll let you discuss these ones. The Jang family.
They're great.
Their apartment is super colorful and super vibrant. I really like that.
Where is my free code of The Sims? probably don't have one for you, buddy. Sorry.
We have Lobo here. He's the sort of rich snob.
Who's that guy's hilarious. He's meant to be...
He's a food critic or art critic.
He's inspired by like a famous fashion guy. I cannot remember the name though because I don't know fashion.
I don't even.
Emma Vane, you can use the keyboards out in public. The whole reason we designed those is so that you could travel with them on like the piano.
Sick. So these, the Karaoke Legends, are a group of sort of friends living together, and they hang out around Planet Honey Pop and just are experts in karaoke. You can might be able to catch them and sing a duet with them, which is cool. And then we have
she's our title character. She's like the front of the box.
Yeah, and I know Jill keeps talking about it. For this pack, we were able to actually create the ability to have pre-made Sims start pregnant. So within like the first couple days of starting your game, you'll notice that Pizzazz will.
Is it Penny? Is she getting pregnant?
I think it's Penny Pizzazz.
Really?
Yeah, she'll grow a little.
Is it her? I don't think it's her.
It's not her?
She's like the famous single person.
Let's see, hold on. Let me see the.
So
Jill is the expert in this.
All right, Vova, I hear you. We're gonna try to show some stuff. Please stop shouting at me. We'll get to it if we can.
All caps. Well, what do we want to see? What else? What else can we see?
Bolette Pochkin. We added dancing and get together. I don't know if we'll make a career because we did the skill and get together.
So Steve is shouting at me, #blame
whoa,
Steve.
Whoa, hey, I'm just pointing at
Steve.
Steve, leave the frame.
You're not.
So Kingston also just build up some chopstick skills. While you eat with chopsticks, your Sims will do derpy things like try to stab food. And
like me when I use chopsticks.
And try to throw it into their mouth, and sometimes food will go flying out of the bowls. So that's a hidden skill that you can build up. It's not actually in the skill panel, but your Sims over time will get better at using chopsticks. Same with the spice tolerance. The more spicy food you'll eat, you'll build up your Sims' hidden spicy tolerance.
So Pascal's 488 is asking which sitcoms inspired us to do these families. For the families, we weren't so much inspired by the families. We tried to create just diverse, interesting stories that showed off different new trades and different new gameplay. We were more inspired from sitcoms for just behaviors in the apartments and situations that happen. And like a lot of the best sitcoms of all time, you know, Seinfeld, Friends, Big Bang Theory, How I Met Your Mother, these are all based in apartments. So we really looked at some of these very classic, famous American sitcoms for inspiration.
One of my favorite things, again, Jill and I covered this in our previous stream, but if you tip the performance busker, you'll actually unlock the outfit, and you can put it on and then start busking in the open street. Let's see if I may have it on me, actually. Change outfit.
So, Print, can switch between households that live in the same apartment building? Yes, you can visit Sims in different apartment buildings. You load in between them if you're visiting them, and of course you can change which family you're controlling, just like Manage Worlds now. New skills. We added the
So basketball is actually tied into fitness.
The athletic skill.
The brand new skill we have is singing skill.
Yeah, we added the singing skill. Yep. We mostly tied into existing skills because basketball ties into fitness. The electric piano ties into the piano skill. Mm-hmm. We added a ton of new content for like cooks. The murals are all about painting skill. A lot of times we have to figure out whether we want to make a new skill just for a new object or tie it into an existing skill, and sometimes it doesn't make sense. Somebody asked about new build feature. The new build feature is lot traits. Do you want to go check that out, actually?
There's lot traits as well as copy architecture,
which
is really good.
Oh, yes.
It's a small feature, which a lot of you may not notice, but I know our builders out there are going to appreciate. So let's actually travel here because I want to build on this lot.
When is release, Amanda? Is it November 1st and November 3rd?
It's November 1st, North America, November 3rd.
Yeah, release is November 1st, North America, November 3rd, rest of world.
Rest of world.
That we ship to.
#rest of world.
#rest of world, #blame Steve.
What?
It's going to pick up. It's already picking up. So I'm going to load into this lot and I'll show you guys
Eight cups of tea. Lot traits are not base game. This is a new feature that we've added.
So some of the lot traits are actually, so the system itself is base game carry forward.
But being able to change it. Well, yeah, we were going to give it back.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, so we just added it for this pack, but everyone will get the base game, but most of the content is tied to city living.
Correct. So there are some lot traits that will be base game, but for the most part, a lot of this stuff is city living specific. So when you go into build mode, you'll be able to open this lot info panel now, and it'll show you your requirements, it'll show you your venue type. We sort of overhauled this entire UI here. And you can click on these little question marks, and much like Sims traits, you're sort of building out this little molecule, you can add various traits that will affect how your Sims behave on the lot. So you can put faster internet, this will improve sort of your programming skill, video gaming and writing, homey, which helps with cooking, mixology. If you really want a challenge, you can sort of make a filthy apartment with gremlins or make it grody also. You can do chef's kitchen that will increase your cooking skill.
One thing is somebody just asked, hey, can you ask Drake why the forums are down? That's not our fault. There's actually, the reason the stream was late to begin with is there's actually a hack. Hackers DDoS, are basically doing a denial of service attack on like Twitter. Our servers, so it's not our fault. Basically, people have taken
Twitter
down the
Twitter just like recovered.
Yeah, Twitter just barely recovered. So that's the reason the stream was down. It's not our fault. It's a DDoS attack from hackers.
So these are some of the new traits. We have Quake Zone, and if you're on a lot with Quake Zone, your screen will suddenly just start shaking. And we even built in magnitudes. So sometimes I think it's from 1 to 10 are the magnitudes of the earthquake or the intensity of the shake. And then your Sims will all react in the world based off of how intense it is. The other feature we have is copy architecture, which I'm really excited about as a builder.
Real quick, folks are asking to see the earthquake. The thing is we could turn on the earthquake trait, but we don't know when they're going to happen. This is not a cheat build, so we don't really have an easy way to cheat it. So we can't really do it, show the earthquake.
And plus, much like the pufferfish death, we don't want to spoil everything. You like play the game, you guys will find a bunch of little secrets. We're sort of just hitting the top layer right now. There is a lot more stuff when you dive in.
Somebody's also asking what's on a ley line. That's sort of a classic, tale. Basically, it increases your chance of twins. You'll be more fertile there.
Yeah. So if you give birth on that lot, there's a chance it'll be twins.
Voltron Games. You're mostly just your Sims react to the earthquake. Items break due to the Gremlins trait. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Gremlins and Penny Pixies are. Penny Pixies are great. So while you're sitting on couches and chairs, you'll all of a sudden see simoleons like tick up, and it's you sort of like finding change
in
the cushions.
Yeah, it's
the couch. And then the gremlins will show up every night. Same with the gnomes. You'll sort of hear, you'll see broken things and stuff falling apart.
And the Simply Nando is saying we can copy stairs, rooms, and roof shapes, right?
Yeah.
Which is what it does.
Yep. So I'm about to go over that right now. So there's this new little widget here on the build.
We can't really show a career in the stream. Sorry. Please stop asking.
So we have the new widget here, which is copy architecture. When you click place it down, and it'll copy all the objects inside of it, all the layout, that it'll make a direct copy of that room, and you can go ahead and just out and everything. So those of you that are trying to make perfectly symmetrical houses, you'll be able to copy all that stuff and move it over. It also allows you to copy roofs. You can copy an entire roof shape, and I know a lot of you like making crazy roofs and like really pointy, different styled roofs. It'll be much easier now with this tool. I believe we can copy, so it'll be roofs and rooms as well, and stairs.
And stairs. Yeah, we're always trying to look for these little details to help make your lives easier. We're listening to the forums, we're listening to you guys here in the streams. A lot of times this stuff takes, months, weeks, years to develop, so we're working on a lot of things. So we're always working on new stuff.
Mm-hmm. Anything else?
Is there anything else we didn't cover, Amanda?
No, I think you guys did a good job.
All right, guys. So let me just wrap it up. The City Living expansion is maybe my favorite that we've done for The Sims 4 so far. It just fundamentally improves on Late Night from The Sims 3. The city is actually dense and beautiful, and it feels like a city. The apartments are sincerely a distinct experience from living in a home in Willow Creek. Living in an apartment feels different. You have a sense of community from the people who come visit you and interact with you and change your life. You have the broken objects and the traits and all these things that change stuff. But then looking out the window, you have so much gameplay that really ties into what a city is about. Again, looking back to late night, almost nothing really had to do anything with the city, but in city living, we've got the festivals and the cultural events, we've got street basketball and murals and protests, we've got new careers, which are a sign of the opportunity that you get by moving into the city. You've got careers that have new gameplay and new behaviors that you can't get living back in Willow Creek. So living in an apartment is different, looking out your window, all these things are different. And this is such a great pack for storytellers. There's all this gameplay to unlock. There's all this progression. It's a really rich platform. And I am super excited for you guys to get this. I think you guys are going to love this. And I think this is going to be your favorite pack so far.
Yep. I've definitely had a lot of fun with it. And I can't wait for you guys to get your hands on it.
And just remember to blame Steve for everything.
Hey, no.
Hashtag
blame Steve.
All right.
You should also tell them that Sims Camp people will have their
stuff
up.
So, yeah. When's their date? Next week?
I think it's next week.
And Monday. Yeah, so we had Sims Camp people should be sharing stuff soon, but also the embargo lifts for the folks from around the world. Just a few weeks ago, I was in Warsaw, Paris, Germany, Cologne. Germany is a country, not a city. I was in Cologne, Germany, but also I was doing live chats with folks in the UK and all over the world. So you guys should see a ton of content, a ton of opinions, a ton of things shared from the community very soon. So if you don't believe us, hopefully you'll believe them. But it was so awesome to see how much people have been reacting to the pack so favorably. So thanks for watching. Check out the City Living soon. Go comment your thoughts on the forums. And above all, blame Steve.
Hashtag blame Steve.
Hashtag blame
Steve. Yeah, I'm sure.